Shabbat Shalom, Israel.
All Israel.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom, Israel.
So,
we the Israelites. We not the Equalites. If we keep God's law, statutes, and commandments, we above all people on the face of the earth. And so we are here today to bring this truth to our people. We don't come out here to get in confrontations with our people. But we do come out here to bring the unadulterated word of the Most High God. And so we come in today to let everyone know what it is that we have to do when this thing is going on, this coronavirus and all these different things that's going on. That they are no different than any other virus. They are no different than the virus that we've been having from years to years. Every year, it's always 30 or 40 people die from the flu. Why they want to talk about it this year? They haven't been talking about it no other year. It's just like the time when they had this flu, the thing out. That's called influenza. Same thing, same symptoms. Now over there in China, they got a new disease coming out now. And so we got to be very, very careful, keep God's laws, statutes, and commandments, so we can keep this coronavirus off us.
That's right.
And if we do those things that God requires of us, we're going to be all right. Because the Bible says it's best to obey God than to obey man.
Amen. That's right.
Nobody said anything about call on the name of the Most High. They just believe what the white man is saying. They believe what the Chinese man is saying. They believe the Africans and all those people that's not a part of our nation. But they don't believe what God says. They're not telling you to go to the store and get you some soup and some crackers. They're not telling you to go get no cough syrup or anything like that. They just continue to press what? Fear inside you. But God has already loosed us from our bounds when he brought us out of the land of Egypt. Am I right, brother?
That's right.
That's what the Most High did. So we don't have to be worried about those things. The only way you're going to catch it, if you start to hang around these other nations, that's what's happening. And so we're going to get into some of these scriptures today so that we can know what we need to be doing in order to be able to get all that God has for us.
That's right.
Matthew chapter 6, verse 5. And when thy prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites.
The Bible says when you pray, you shouldn't be like the hypocrites. Read.
Or for they love to pray standing in the synagogues.
Because they love to pray standing in the synagogue. The Bible says don't be like the hypocrites. That's what we see. We see people standing all around and holding hands in circles. But the Bible tells us not to be like hypocrites. The Bible tells us that's not the way that we pray. But we believe what man say and not what God say. Am I right, brother?
That's right.
We need to start to believe in the Most High God. Read on, brother.
And in the corners of the streets.
They be everywhere praying so they can be seen. Read.
That they may be seen of men.
That they may what, brother?
That they may be seen of men.
That they may be seen of men.
Verily I say unto you, they have their reward.
They have their reward. It don't make no difference about you trying to close that door. This truth still going out, brother. Regardless of whether you want to hear it or not, this truth still going out. We don't care nothing about that. This truth going out. We don't care nothing about any of that. This truth is going to go out regardless. You damn go cool. Read.
But thy wind, thy praise enter into thy closet.
When you pray, go to your hiding place. Go to your private secret place. Read.
And when thy has shut thy door, pray to thy Father, which is in secret.
Pray to the Most High that is in secret.
And thy Father, which seen in secret, shall reward thee openly.
All the things that he give you in secret, all that relationship, all that talking that it is in secret, he's going to give it to you openly. He's going to let the world know who he is and who his servants are. when you obey and follow what it is that he requires of you. Stop being like your oppressor. That's what caused us to be in the situation we're in today, trying to be like the other nations. But God tells us that we should be separate. That's why our prayers not getting answered, because we're trying to be like the white man, the so-called Indians, the little East Indians, Arabs, Chinese, Japanese, Africans. We ain't no stinking African. Learn your history. Africa sold you to slavery. Him and the Arab man sold you into slavery to the white man. Am I right, brother?
That's Amen. Right.
Come on, y'all, get with me.
Amen.
Be in the spirit. In the spirit. Come on,
yes,
y'all.
Yes, sir.
Read what you got, brother.
Think that they shall be heard for their much speaking.
See, they think because they want to make a long prayer and everything, God is hearing them. God ain't hearing nothing that you got to say. God ain't even hearing you. God don't even love all you other nations. That's what your preachers in your church tell you, that God love everybody. Show me in the Bible where God love everybody at. It's not in there. Read.
Be not ye therefore like unto them.
Uh-huh. Don't be like them.
For your Father knoweth what things ye have need of before ye ask him.
See, you don't need to be praying 1,000 minutes or 2 or 3 hours. Oh, Lord, oh, God, please, this and that. He already know what you need. He's the author, thinker, and finisher of all things. He knows everything that you need. So you don't need to go to him with all these drawn-out prayers. Read.
After this matter, therefore, pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Ain't nobody going up nowhere. Ain't no such thing as no rapture. It say thy kingdom come. The kingdom is going to come down from heaven. Ain't nobody going up there. Ain't no such thing as no rapture. It ain't no even talk about no rapture in the Bible. Nowhere in the Bible can you find anything that they're talking about a rapture.
That's right.
That the seminary
that's right.
has taught you job, low down, cool, lazy pastors.
Taking it.
That's right.
Read, brother.
Luke chapter 11, verse 2.
Read, brother.
And he said unto them.
What did he say, brother?
When ye pray, say, Our Father, which art in heaven.
Uh-huh.
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed what?
Hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed be the Most High's name. Read.
Thy kingdom come.
What happened?
Thy kingdom come.
Thy kingdom gonna come from up there. Thy kingdom gonna come. Read.
Thy will be done.
Uh-huh.
As in heaven, so in earth.
As in heaven, so in earth. So when you go back to church, you tell your pastor that he been telling you a lie. That ain't no kingdom gonna come. You ain't going up to no kingdom. There ain't no rapture. You tell your pastor that the Bible says that the kingdom is going to come to all of those that keep God's law, statutes, and commandments. That's what the Bible says. Read.
Job chapter 23, verse 12.
Read, brother.
Neither have I gone back from the commandment of his lips.
Read.
I have esteemed the words of his mouth more than my necessary food.
Read that again, that last part, read it again.
Verse 12, neither have I gone back from the commandment of his lips.
See, nobody, they're not turning, they're not transgressing, they're not going against the God's commandments, read.
I have esteemed the words of his mouth more than my necessary food.
More than what did he necessarily needs to do? Read, brother.
Matthew 18, chapter 18, verse 21.
Read.
Then came Peter to him and said, Lord, how oft shall my brother sin against me?
Uh-huh, read.
And I forgive him till 7 times.
70 times, 7 times. Read.
Jesus saith unto him,
uh-huh.
I say unto thee, until 7 times, but until 70 times 7.
Until how many times, brother?
70 times 7.
Until 70 times 7.
Therefore is the kingdom of heaven likened unto a certain king, which would take account of his servants.
See, that's what they was doing back in the days of Nebuchadnezzar and Nebuchadnezzar and Nebuchadnezzar. They had so many Nebuchadnezzars, it's ridiculous. And all those kings, there wasn't but one that God had ordained them, the Israelites, to obey. That was during the time when they was going through the things in Babylon. See?
First Chronicles chapter 29, verse 11.
Read, brother.
Thine, O Lord, is the greatest, and the power, and the glory, and the victory, and the majesty, for all that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thy art exalted as head above all.
See, the Most High is exalted as the head above everything and everybody. Am I right?
That's right.
There's nothing or no one that is higher than the Most High God. God is the highest of all. So why do we continue to want to obey the white man? Why we don't obey God? Why we not going to the stores and getting cough syrup and getting soups and stuff? But we going to get a mask to put on our face that's not going to help us. Why are we doing all those things that are not true? Why are we not obeying God, but we are obeying these pagan principles that the world has stored upon us? When are we going to start coming back to our God, who is able to heal us from all our sins, iniquities, and diseases? Am I right, brother?
That's what the Bible says.
Read.
Mark chapter 11, verse 24 and 25.
Read, my brother.
Therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that ye receive them.
See, when you pray, and you pray with doubt, or you don't pray with the assurance that whatever it is that you asking for, that the Most High is going to give it to you. Read, brother.
And ye shall have them.
And you shall have them.
And when ye stand praying, forgive if ye have aught against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses.
You see, if you want to go to the Most High God and you want to pray and all this stuff, but you don't want to forgive your brother, you don't want to forgive your sister, the Most High God is not going to forgive you. Because he had to forgive you of your sins, so he expects for you to forgive your brother and your sister, your Hebrew brother and your Hebrew sister. He's not talking about all nations. Read.
That's right.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 13.
Read, my brother.
Forbearing one another.
See, it says forbearing one another. Read.
And for forgiving one another.
You got to forgive one another. Read.
If any man have a quarrel against any.
If a man have any kind of problem against his brother or his sister.
Even as the Machiav forgive you, so also do ye.
Just like the Most High God has forgiven you, if you got a problem with your brother and your sister, the Most High said that you should do what, brothers?
Forgive.
You should do what?
Forgive.
The Bible says that we should do the same thing that Yahawashah did. He forgave us. And so we have to forgive our brothers and our sisters as well. If not, God is not going to be hearing us. Am I right?
That's right.
Read.
Proverbs chapter 28, verse 9. He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law.
If you turn away